I'm Catalijne Smulders, and I'm a participant of the open set. I'm an artist also, I'm very happy that I have some time to explain and speak a bit about my practice. What I actually do is I work with special groups of people, often groups that are considered to be like disordered or non-normal or outside any kind of norm. For example, I worked with people with aphasia. Aphasia is a speaking disorder that you get after a stroke, and the symptoms are kind of ranging between not being able to speak at all or just being confused about the words you use. I also worked with people with chorea atetosis. It's called the dance illness, and it's actually a kind of spasm. It comes because a kind of a disorder in the brain, and it actually means that people cannot control their movement. So they are, they are bothered by constantly being moved because the muscles, they get tense or they lose. I mean, this is explained in a very simple way. And I work with children a lot. It's the youngest children. It's the age between 0 and 6 years old. This is the age that they start to learn how to speak first, and then how to read, and then how to write. And I do this in Zuidoost neighborhood. I have a non-profit foundation. There's 20 artists working for it, and they visit the schools. It's preschools. And they visit it on like monthly basis, or sometimes every 2 weeks. They come to the groups and they have like hours that they actually play with the children. And playing is kind of a very simple word for what they do. But they actually bring in a certain other way of learning in the groups, because these groups are very much focused on learning language. And I thought it is more interesting to use the body more, or to use like visual forms or like musical forms to get the children actually into playing. And then I kind of motivate that this is also kind of learning for them. We do this for 5 years now, and it's subsidized by the Amsterdam gemeente. But for this short talk, I want to speak a bit about the work I did with the aphasic speakers, with a woman with aphasia. What I did together with her, I worked also like for a long time with her, is first to get to know her and to find out during encounters that I have with her what's actually is this aphasia, and how does it manifest itself in everyday communication. So I went to her and I talked with her. We did singing together, we did like cooking together, we did many, many exercises, we did writing together, all kinds of things. And then after this, after finding out what is exactly her speaking disorder about, and how does it affect communication also with me, and how do I feel when I am with her, I decided to make a performance together with her. And in this performance, I asked a group of vocal improvisers, a choir, to actually interact with the speaker and how she speaks. I did this in several occasions, and every time the piece is a kind of a reading, and every time it adapts to the context of the place I perform it, as the text that is used adapts to another place, but also the structure of the improvisation we create. And I think maybe, yeah, I wrote it down because I thought it might be nice to read it out for you loud. So it's actually about this aphasic speaker, Tamara, and she initiates every reading by serving as the initial sonic and visual focus point of the performance. So actually what she says will be the first input of a performance that will be worked on. And then the goal is that in the reading, the disability, because when she starts, Tamara, when she starts reading, you can imagine that she cannot actually speak very fast. So she speaks very slow, and there's actually a lot of silence. And then her disability is highlighted in a way. You can also always see it in as soon as she starts to speak, the audience is really like immediately very, very, very attentive. But then actually how I see it is that my goal is to kind of reframe this attitude of the audience towards Tamara within the 20 minutes or the 30 minutes that we have into something else, so that it's not only Tamara and exposing her disordered voice or the beauty of it, but it's also about reframing it and showing it that it also has qualities and also that there's a certain ability. And then what I am actually looking for is that is kind of perfect and imperfect binary, that it kind of blurs. And I do that by inviting a choir, like improvisation choir. And I ask them actually to play and explore the qualities of the aphasic speech. And this can range from being like hard, confrontating. So you can imagine that when Tamara speaks a word and she cannot really pronounce it very well, that when a choir member mimics this or copies this, it's kind of a confrontation. But it can also mean that, for example, but this is a very technical thing, when you speak in a certain rhythm, Tamara also can more easily adapt to that rhythm, and she can speak more fluid. So there's actually, the choir can choose either they like highlight the disordered voice, the disorder of the voice, or they can make it sound more fluid. And they can play between these two binaries. Also what I wanted to tell is that the instructions I give to the choir are based actually on the qualities of the speech I encounter when I am meeting Tamara. So first, this first period, it's sessions, it's more like sessions very private. I just research what kind of qualities the speech has. And then in the second part of the project, when I invite different people, like a choir, sometimes I invite dancers, then I give them actually the same conditions as that I found out when I was with Tamara. And I think maybe this is not clear, so I thought it might be nice to give you some example. Is that, for example, when you ask Tamara about her speaking disorder, I borrowed some words from her. I asked her once at the table, and I will read it out for you. This is how she would explain it to you. When you ask her, what is aphasia? She will tell you this. I search for words. I slow talk. I seeking words. I have things. I have a head. but I can hardly pronounce them. I an object, no able. I use hand gesture. This is what she would tell. I mean, this is of course me speaking it, and I'm actually more fast than she would be. But this is what you can understand from her disorder. And then this is actually when you Google like aphasia. So you can imagine that this already provides like a very rich material to work with the choir, because what I ask them actually to do is to also, or what I am actually looking for, is to also speak and sing in this way. So when they read, when Tamara is reading in a performance, I also ask them, or to respond on it, on this in this way. And I think maybe it's nice to show a video of one of the sessions. And it starts with me asking some questions.
What does she activate?
She activates
Thank you.
What's not in this video is that actually this is the part that the choir actually starts to improvise without Tamara, and then it becomes like this more etheric mm-hmm. Tamara sings. She's a singer, so I asked mm-hmm. Tamara to finish off with a song, and I asked her which song she really likes, and it's an 80s song. It's called Circle, which created very great contrast also with the singing. So then she starts to sing alone, and I started to sing with her. I'm not a singer at all, but I also do this because I need to again work balance. With this balance. So I also have to show my, like she showed so much fragility and vulnerability, I also have to do it myself to make it like even again, and also open enough for the audience to not be like totally overwhelmed.
Yeah, overwhelmed.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I hope it was a bit clear.